learning difficulties. Our view, and we've been looking at this in some detail throughout the consultation, as we have been exploring the other options, is that there is capacity to extend both of those two primary schools to more than adequately respond to the needs of the children who currently attend Lyndale School. So, I genuinely have not put this forward as second best. Based on a whole range of factors, it is a genuine belief that those children can be well schooled, well cared for, have their health needs met, with parents over time feeling confident in the care and education their children receive in those settings. So that's the primary issue with the children with PMLD currently attending the Lyndale School. In respect to children attending West Kirby Residential School, as I say, they are children with a different set of needs, and our job all the time is to look at how those children could be maintained within our mainstream special schools for secondary age children in Wimmera. The reason why there are children at West Kirby Residential School is that at this point in time, our schools cannot meet their needs. But it is my belief, and there is evidence I put forward, that within the primary CLD sector, we can meet the needs of the children who currently attend the Lyndale School.
And also, I think it's in the reality of life, which is how very much I'm talking about the people, West Kirby Residential is a school, it's also a course of business. It isn't ours. So it's a commercial transaction between the council and our body. And any commercial transaction, we have to pay the price we have to pay. Clearly, if we decline not to send those children there when we've got, that's been identified as the most appropriate place for them, we would have to meet additional transport costs to reach schools off the border. So again, it is a different setting. I understand why,
it could be the different needs and the certainly it's not something that you can get a consensus to, but it's one that within in consultation with the special schools, kind of broad agreement that the system we're introducing was a reasonable start in funding for special schools going forward. We did recognise at the time that this course would cause some difficulties and would need to be reviewed within a period of time. And we do plan to do a review of the system within the next 12 months.